we have to improve the efficiency of the NOx after treatment system.
Right.
That is what we have to do in the next years.
This was the question that I posed to Dr. Helmut Endres, who's a good old buddy of mine because he's from the Audi days, and I literally said to him, are we going to make it? You know, it's a bit like, you know, when Kennedy said we're going up to the moon, there's things we're going to have to invent on the way. And he said it's a remarkable journey that they're going on. But he said, yeah, we feel very, very good about making... And he drew me this chart on a big, I'm going to keep it for posterity, on a piece of paper. And he drew this little square, which is the bin five. And he said, Len, we have a really, really good chance of getting there for 2007. So I was encouraged.
And just to clarify, Dr. Endres is the head of powertrain.
He's head of group engineering engine development.
Yeah, he's the head guy as far as engines. Any other questions? Good questions there.
How many states can you sell these two vehicles in right now?
Frank, it's a 45-state.
45-state.
45-state car. Yes, Kelly.
Did you make this improvement in emissions? Does it correspondingly improve fuel economy?
As we get ourselves to bin five, do we get better fuel economy? Mr. Dornkamp or maybe Stefan?
We developed, also the first step was to introduce a TDI. That allows us to reduce the fuel consumption about 20% in comparison to the three chamber engine. And we improve now the friction of the engine. We will have the new generation. I saw the chart with the four valve engine. That also allows us to reduce the fuel consumption about 3 to 5%. In all, I think for this bin 5 standard, every after treatment systems, particulate trap and also NOx absorber will increase the fuel consumption. And we have to work on that we have the standards. We can achieve the standard what we have today.
Yes, Roger. I'm sorry.
Volkswagen chose to go with the unit injector over a common rail diesel system like Mercedes uses?
The question was, why did we choose pump-a-diesel over the common rail system that some of you may have seen in other products?
We make a comparison between 15 years ago from now, make a comparison between all injection systems what are possible. And we came to the conclusion that the unit injector system has the best potential for the future to increase the injection pressure and also give us the injection curve during the injection period. And that is what the diesel engine need to have the best combustion process. That was one point. And the other point was we had the tool valve engine. And also our competitors had the four-valve engine. And we had to decide to develop a new cylinder head, for example, and a new TDI generation and on the other hand. And that was the reason because we decided for the unit injector because this is for us the highest potential for the future. That was the main reason.
I'm going to let Warren have a chance here because we only got a few more questions. I'm sorry, Frank. Go ahead, and then I'll get to you.
What's BIN? What does that mean, BIN?
What does BIN stand for?
Yeah.
I'm embarrassed to say I don't know.
I don't know.
That's the stage.
Yeah, there we go.
That is actually just the stage of the Tier 2 requirement with BIN 10, BIN 9, and so on.
Close.
Is there, Norbert, is there does it abbreviate something,
no,
BIN?
It is not an abbreviation.
It's
just BIN like a container
like a container, right.
Okay.
Basically, as I understand it, the government is allowing us under Tier 2, EPA Tier 2, they're giving us these bins to continue to sell the diesel cars. So they're containments within, their slots within the EPA too.
Okay.
Yeah, Frank.
What are you projecting in sales for the
TDI, Touareg, and the Passat, and in each case, what percentage of the total Passat and total Touareg sales are you projecting for the diesels?
Okay.
Do you want it? Yeah, well, we're looking at within a range, like within the Passat, we'd like to get to about 12,000 units, which was, we'd like to get up between 10 and 15%. We'd like it, I mean, and the way it's going, it would go more towards the 15%. So where we're in a range. That's obviously with the exception of the Touareg, which is really supply constrained and acting as a bit of a halo for the brand and the halo for the technology at the moment. But as we said earlier, we see some models like the Jetta wagon gets up to 70%, and particularly in Canada where it's 40% overall. So 10 to 15, overall, to answer your question, we'd like to sell 32,000 out of the 300 being diesel. But that's because there are some ranges we're not as strong in terms of the penetration.
You said 12,000 units represents 10 to 15% of total Passat sales.
That's right.
What's the comparable figure for the Touareg?
For the Touareg, it's much lower because we're trying to do over 35,000 Touaregs, and the V10 will be a lot lower than that. But we could get more, we'd put that percentage up. But overall, I think if you think of a full year at 300, it's not a full year of the Passat, obviously, so if we're trying to sell 32,000, then when we get a full year, we can crank it up to a little more than the 10% where it's
just... We're going
to
take...
Yes, 15% is a goal.
One more question, you guys, because I just noticed my watch here, and we're woefully behind schedule here.
Where will the cars be built, Tony?
Wherever they're built. Germany, Mexico.
The Passat is built in
Bratislava.
Mosul.
And
the Touareg is in
Bratislava. Jet and Beetle down in Puebla.
Okay, folks, we are going to have to get started here. We do, as you know, have two drive days, everybody. We have two drive days. We have two different separate courses. You will have a chance to talk to all of these folks up on the stage, as well as some of the other folks up.